is at the top and the less or the least reactive is at the bottom. So you can use the chat or you can use the mic to state the answer. Some elements are shown in order. As you can see, answer the question using the list of elements. You just have to use these elements to answer the question. Each element may be used once, more than once, or not at all. Like maybe you will use any of them as to write the answer, or maybe it is not used at all. So the first one, identify the non-metals. So which one is a non-metal? Sodium is a metal. Yeah, that's right. So sodium is a metal, magnesium. So the only non-metal which you will see here is hydrogen. If there was a carbon in the series, then carbon is also. You can use a chat or you can use your mic. What is easy for you, you can use that to state the answer. Then a metal which is stored under oil. So the metal which is stored under oil or the metal which is highly reactive must be stored under the oil. So which metal is a highly reactive here? When you see, you will find sodium. So sodium is highly reactive. That's why we should store under the oil. If it is exposed to the surrounding oxygen or air, instantly it will react. Then the main component of a steel. So steel is basically, there are different types of steel, low carbon steel or high carbon steel.
Yes, Mr. Aluminium.
Steel. Steel is actually main, the base of a steel is iron. Iron is present, like example, if we have a low carbon steel, if it is a low carbon steel, it contains a smaller percentage of a carbon and it contains greater percentage of iron. Iron is always there. High carbon steel, it contains like 3%, 5% carbon and low. So name an element which is the main component of a steel. So that is iron. All types of steel, the base is the iron. You can have a low carbon, high carbon, stainless steel. You may have a wrought iron. So different, all of them consist of, all type of steel consist of iron. So the main component is iron. Next, a metal with a 3 electron in the outer shell. So metal with a 3 electron in the outer shell, it means they're asking about group 3 element. So you can identify the group 3 element from this, that from the list, we can say it's aluminium. That's right. So it will be aluminium. A metal that is found in a brass. Brass is an alloy. Brass is a mixture of copper and zinc. So the two elements which mix together, so you can write any one of them because both are present in the list. So even copper is right answer. If you write copper, Cu, that is correct. If you write zinc, that is also correct. Because they are asked metal found in brass. So we can find copper also in brass and we can find zinc as well in brass. Then the metal that form a chloride of type Xl2 and XCl3. So what does it mean? It means this element is having a variable oxidation number. Like it is forming XCl2 and XCl3. So it is oxidation, its oxidation number is not same or it's, so it has a variable oxidation state. For iron, iron can be +2, iron can be +3. But for copper, copper is can be +1 and +2. So iron and copper both are transition element when you check the series here, the reactivity series which is given. But because iron is having a valency of +2 and +3 and copper is having a valency, can have a valency of common valency +1 and +2. That's why the answer here should be iron again. Why we choose iron? Why not copper? Because copper cannot have a valency +3. Copper can have +1, maximum +2. Iron can have +1, +2, +3. Name the main ores of zinc. Ore means like naturally occurring compound. in nature, how they exist. So what is the main ore of a zinc? That is zinc blend or a zinc sulfide. And aluminium, that is bauxite. So bauxite is the main ore of aluminium. If it was iron, then it will be hematite. In an experiment, a sample of aluminium appeared less reactive than expected. Why? So what is the reason why aluminium does not react instantly compared to other metal? Because whenever you have a piece of aluminium, aluminium is having an oxide layer, a protective oxide layer. Like example, if this is aluminium, so this aluminium will react with surrounding, and the top layer of aluminium is always aluminium oxide. And this aluminium oxide is less, because metal oxide compared to metals are less reactive. So the top layer of aluminium is always aluminium oxide. So what is the reason why aluminium appeared to be less reactive than expected? Because it has protective oxide layer. So there's a layer of oxygen or aluminium oxide layer on the top of aluminium. That's why when we add any substance like acid, it will not react instantly. First, the oxide will react, and oxide reaction is very slow. Once oxide layer is removed, then the aluminium reaction starts, and that will be faster. Name two metals from the list which can be extracted by reducing their ore with carbon, or which are less reactive than carbon. The carbon is between aluminium, the position of a carbon in a reactivity, it is between aluminium and zinc. So carbon is more reactive than any of these elements. So which two metals, their oxides can be removed by carbon? For example, if we have a zinc oxide, if we react with a carbon, because carbon is more reactive, so it will displace zinc and it will form zinc metal and carbon monoxide or dioxide. Same thing if we have iron oxide, iron 3 oxide or iron 2 oxide. So same thing happens. Carbon is more reactive than iron, so carbon will displace this iron. As a result, it will produce iron and carbon dioxide or monoxide, depending on the equation. Same thing, if you have a copper oxide, hydrogen is a non-metal, but in the question, they ask for metal only. So if you have a copper oxide, carbon is more reactive, so carbon will displace this copper. As a result, it will produce carbon monoxide. So the question is, which oxides or which metal oxide can be reduced by carbon? So you can mention either zinc, iron, or copper. So we can mention here zinc, the first one, and then iron. You don't have to write a symbol, you have to name. So I'm writing a symbol, but you have to name, you have to write zinc and iron. In part E, zinc granule is added to copper sulfate. So as you can see, zinc is more reactive. When you check the reactivity which is given, zinc is top and copper is there at the bottom. So if you have a solution of copper sulfate solution is blue in color due to the presence of copper ion. So copper sulfate solution contain copper ion and sulfate ion. And now what we are doing, we are adding a zinc granules. Pieces of zinc are added. So as a result, because zinc is more reactive, so zinc plus copper sulfate, zinc is more reactive, so it will displace the copper out from its compound. When zinc displaces the copper, the product will be zinc sulfate plus copper metal. So this is blue in color, appearance of copper sulfate, so original color will be blue. When zinc sulfate is formed, this is a colorless solution, does not have any color. And this copper metal is produced. What is the appearance of a copper metal? Copper is brown or even pink is acceptable. These are the colors which you can say for a copper metal. And this reaction is known as a displacement reaction. So according to question, first they ask, name the pink solid. The second one, name the colorless solution. So the pink solid, which is formed because copper will be displaced. So as a result, when copper will be displaced, it will be a copper metal here. So the pink solid is copper. Name a colorless solution. So what is this colorless solution? It is actually zinc sulfate. You will write in words. I'm using a formula just to save the time. And in terms of particle, why the rate of a reaction increases when the temperature increases? Whenever you write the answer, first thing you should check the marks so that you can write according to the marks. So it's of 3 marks. So what is the distribution of the marks here? First thing you will mention, when we increase the temperature, the particles will have more energy. That is 1 mark. Then the second thing, particles have greater collagen. That is 2nd mark. And the 3rd mark, greater number of the particles will have energy more than activation energy. So it will increase the energy of the particles, or we can say speed of the particles, energy or speed or kinetic energy, this all same thing. Then there will be more collagens and there will be greater number of the particles. With energy more than activation. So these points, whenever a question is there related to effect of temperature on the speed or the rate, so these are the points we should include. Suggest 2 other ways to increase the rate of a reaction. So how we can increase the rate or the speed of a reaction? We can increase concentration. That is one thing. We can increase the surface area using much like a powdered zinc. Or we can also use a catalyst. Temperature is already they mentioned. So if you write here increase temperature, you will not get any mark because they already mentioned here why the rate of a reaction increases with the temperature. So if you write temperature, you will not get any mark. You can increase the surface area. So if you increase the surface area, large surface area, it will react faster, or you can increase the concentration, or you can also use a catalyst.